Hey you guys, this is Manali and I'm back with yet another really festive recipe for Diwali. We are going to make pan cheesecake truffles now. If you have been following my blog for a while, you know that I love making recipes with pan. Over the last few years, I have made so many desserts using pan, like pan cheesecake, pan laddu, pan kheer and whatnot. So I'm back with yet another recipe, including pan, of course, and we are making pan cheesecake truffles today. They are really easy to make, they look so festive, and they make the perfect treat for Diwali. So let's get started. These are the beautiful pan leaves that I got from Indian store. I'm going to just remove the stalk and then I'm also going to chop them. Just roughly chop them. You don't need to chop them fine because we are going to blend this with some cream to make a fine paste. Well, not a fine paste, but a paste. So we have chopped these roughly. So we are going to make a paste with cream, pan leaves and some rose water and kevra water. So this is heavy cream. This is a teaspoon of rose water and some kevra water. If you don't have kevra water, that's okay. You can just add more of the rose water. And now we are going to make a paste. So it looks something like this. And we are going to set this aside and then we are going to work on the next steps. So we are going to make some cookie crumbs now. I'm using Paleji because Paleji just, it reminds me of my childhood, and whenever I think of Indian sweets and I want to incorporate some cookie into it, Paleji is always my choice. But you can use any cookie here, like graham crackers, like digestives, whatever you prefer. So now our cookie crumb is ready and now we are going to mix everything and make the pan cheesecake truffles. I'm using my stand mixer here, but if you don't have a stand mixer, you can use a hand blender or you can even mix with a spatula or using a whisk, but a stand mixer makes it so easy. So I'm going to add the cookie crumbs that I prepared. Then I'm adding some cream cheese. Make sure it's at room temperature, that's very important. Then I'm adding some gulkand because we of course need pan with gulkand. There's no pan dessert without gulkand in it. So we are adding some gulkand, which is a rose petal preserve. Then I have some crushed fennel seeds here. I crush them using a spice grinder, just roughly crush them. We don't want a powder because we want that bite, and I've added that. And lastly, we have the pan leaves paste that we prepared earlier. So I'm going to add that in as well. So adding that, and everything goes together in the stand mixer. And then I'm just going to run it until it's all mixed well together. So now this is all mixed well together. Look at this beautiful green color. It's all from pan leaves. If you want, you can add some food color if you want to make it really bright green, but I think this will do. So I'm just going to scrape the sides. The mixture for my pan cheesecake truffles is now ready. Now I'm going to use a cookie scoop and I'm going to make small balls out of it and place on my cookie sheet, which I have lined with parchment paper. So this just helps me make equal size truffles. You don't have to use a cookie scoop. If you don't have one, you can just use your hands, but this just makes it easier and it also makes sure that they are of equal size. So So I'm just going to place them on this cookie sheet. And this makes around 25 truffles, but it can make less or more depending on how big you make your truffles. So this is a mini ice cream scoop or a cookie scoop which I'm using, and that with that it makes around 25. I have placed all my cheesecake truffles on this cookie sheet, and now I'm going to freeze this for 15-20 minutes, or you can place it in the refrigerator for about an hour. We need this to firm up before we can dip this in chocolate. So these are my cheesecake truffles after they're out of the freezer. As you can see, they're really nice and hard, so they're perfect to dip in chocolate now. So I'm going to dip them in white chocolate, and I'm using melted wafers here, melting wafers. Why I like to use them is because you don't need to temper them, and you can just straight away use them to dip these cheesecake truffles. If you're using regular chocolate, then you will need to temper it so that it doesn't lose its shape when it's left at room temperature and doesn't melt in your hands. So I'm going to use melting wafers, and let's dip them in chocolate. So once I dip the cheesecake truffles in the chocolate, I garnish them with this candied fennel just to make it look pretty and festive for Diwali. So you can find these at any Indian grocery store. I used a mix of green, red, and all these multiple colors so that it looks perfect for Diwali. This is ready now. You just need to let it set for a few minutes in order for the chocolate to set, and then it's ready to be enjoyed. I hope you guys will give this recipe a try. It's one of my favorites. It's perfect if you want to gift it to your friends and family. Just wrap them in small cute gift boxes, and these will make the perfect edible gifts. Hope you guys enjoyed this recipe, and I'll see you guys next time with yet another recipe. Until then, take care, and I wish you all a very, very happy Diwali.